Welcome to Skedline Talks. I'm your host, Rosen Castillo. This past month, designers, models, and fashion fiends alike have traveled to New York, London, Milan, and Paris to see what the fashion world has in store for us. As Paris Fashion Week comes to a close, marking the end of the fall-winter presentation season, we have a Fashion Week roundup. I am joined by Humber Fashion Arts and Business student and founder of Spectator Vintage, Claire Palmer. Thank you for being here.
Thanks for having me.
So what were some of your highlights from this presentation season? I know that you've sent us a few photos. So we have one from House of Holland.
Yeah, so this look is kind of an army look, which we've been seeing a lot of this year in camo, head to toe, whether it's in your pants or in your coat. This is kind of a different play on that, longer army green coat with the quilted pattern. And what I love about it is that tie. I think you could do a lot with that. Personally, I'm kind of a vintage lover and love to thrift, so I'd probably go to Army Surplus and try to find some type of utility piece there to work into that type of look. And then I think the French beret is a little different piece of the army fashion that we haven't seen before that they're trying to bring in, and I like it.
Mm-hmm. It's very militarized, but not too heavy, not like you're ready to go to battle.
Yeah, it's formal and wearable.
And you also brought us a few looks from Paul Castello as well. Mm-hmm. So what are we looking at here?
So these are some really bold and strong pieces, which I like. So these are some bolder pieces that we saw in the Fashion Week. The head-to-toe, same fabric top to bottom is another theme that we're seeing repeated here. The darker looks are really popular for the fall and winter seasons. I love that there in that photo, the belt she has on, the leather belt with the bag. I've been seeing a lot of those belts with bags on them this year, which I think are really cool. Something I haven't seen until recently, and so I'd like to see a lot more of that, and I think there's a lot of creativity to be used there.
Mm-hmm. It's still like a militarized look, but definitely a bit more upscale, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This season, the fashion world also suffered a loss with the death of Karl Lagerfeld. While we have yet to see his final show with Chanel, what did you think about his last Fendi show?
Yeah, Lagerfeld was renownedly iconic for predicting trends and influencing them. This tribute was a really beautiful show that they did. His signature was everywhere, whether it was on the runway or in the wardrobe itself. The very uniform look, but with interesting elements. You always like to keep it interesting, keep it a little different, have little pieces of the outfit that catch your eye and scream, yeah, Lagerfeld. And that's kind of what helped him make him his name and his designs for Fendi and Chanel in the past. As well as he was always using the best models, like Naomi Campbell, Kate Moss. Like he was just the best. And to live to 85 and have that much influence, even at the very end, it's amazing. And he'll be missed.
Yeah, it was definitely interesting to see a lot of the collars and like the blazers. That's definitely like a very Karl look. Mm-hmm. I find like you always picture him wearing like the all black and white with like that kind of clean look. And you do see it here, but with more earth tones and pops of color. And he even had Gigi Hadid close the show, which was amazing to see as well. Mm-hmm. And now I couldn't end the show without talking about Zendaya and Tommy Hilfiger's collaboration, which was hands down probably my favorite part about this presentation season. You had Grace Jones, who was 70 years old, walking the runway. If I'm like that at 70, I would be amazed. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about the looks.
Yeah, Grace Jones topping it off definitely was part of what made this a highlight of the Paris Fashion Week. The colors were beautiful, again, they're on theme with the long coats, and they kind of pulled together a 70s disco vibe with almost like a working woman look, because these are some professional, pretty serious shapes that they've brought to us here. that
very clean, very like work friendly, but also very elegant and kind of sexy.
Yeah, exactly. Here with the mom shorts, but the collar's still there, and the leather is a trend as well. The brown leather for was all throughout the 70s, and they had a lot of denim too, which is iconic. Iconic for the 70s trend. It was just really beautiful to see Zendaya be able to put her signature on this brand that has been renownedly not very diverse. Zendaya brought in an all black cast for the models, and it was just really refreshing and a great show.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's all the time we have for today. Thank you again for joining me, Claire. Where can people find you?
You can find me at Speckadert Vintage on Instagram and Facebook, and can also find my personal account at Claire_Palmer.
Amazing. I'm Rosen Casill. Thanks for watching Skedline Talks.
Thank you.